So guys, in our last video, we covered the two article types, les articles définis and les articles indéfinis. So let's continue. Les articles contractés, contracted articles. So contracted articles can be categorized again into a and the. Okay, a in French means to or at. The means of or from. Okay, so now what we are going to do is we are going to add les articles définis, definite articles, into a, and later we will do that with the also. Okay, so if I add definite articles with a plus le will become o, a plus la will become ala, a plus L apostrophe will become AL apostrophe, and A plus LE will become O, AUXO. So AUO is used with masculine singular nouns, ALA is used with feminine singular nouns, AL apostrophe is used with masculine singular or feminine singular nouns, but the nouns which are starting with a vowel. Okay, that means singular noun starting with a vowel. And AUXO is used with plural nouns. It could be masculine plural or it could be feminine plural noun. Let's see them with the help of example. Il parle au garçon. He speaks to the boy. So boy is masculine singular, garçon. So we have used O, okay? And all these contracted articles, O, ala, al apostrophe, AUX means to the or at the, okay? Next is ala. Il parle à la fille. He speaks to the girl. Next, al apostrophe. Il parle à l'homme. Now, homme is a masculine singular noun, but it's starting with a vowel. So we will use il apostrophe. He speaks to the man. Now let's see the plural form, how to use o. Il parle aux garçons. He speaks to the boys. Il parle aux filles. He speaks to the girls. Il parle aux hommes. He speaks to the men. So in all these cases, plural nouns are used. It could be masculine plural, feminine plural, or even a plural noun starting with a vowel. But if it is plural, we will use AUX. Now we have to note here that with proper nouns, A will be used. Okay? O, ala, al apostrophe, AUX will not be used with a proper noun. For example, il parle à Nikita. He speaks to Nikita. So Nikita is a proper noun. So we will use a and not ala. Il parle à Rahul. He speaks to Rahul. Now Rahul is a masculine singular noun, but it's a proper noun. So no o. We're not using au. We will use a. Next, one more example. Il parle a Nikita e a Rahul. He speaks to Nikita and to Rahul. So here, everywhere you can see, we are not using any other contracted form. Okay, only a will be used. Now let's come on to the second part of article contracté. Okay, which is the. Now, as I've already told you, the means of or from. We are going to add les articles définis to the. Okay, so this will now become of the or from the. The plus le becomes du. The plus la will be de la. The plus l apostrophe will become de l apostrophe. And the plus le will be de. Now du will be used with masculine singular noun. De la will be used with feminine singular nouns.
The L apostrophe will be used with masculine singular or feminine singular noun, but again starting with a vowel. And the plus le becomes they, and they is used with masculine plural or feminine plural nouns. Let's try to understand them with the help of examples. C'est le stylo du garçon. This is the pen of the boy. So garçon is masculine singular. So for of the we have used du. C'est le stylo de la fille. Now the noun is fille. Fille is feminine. So we have used de la. The pen. This is the pen of the girl. Next. C'est le stylo de l'homme. Now the pen is of the man. Man is homme. Homme is masculine singular but starting with a vowel. So this will be c'est le stylo de l'homme. This is the pen of the man. Now let's see how to use the plural form of les articles contractés des. Ce sont les stylos des garçons. These are pens of the boys. So boys, garçon is plural, so we have used des. Ce sont les stylos des filles. These are the pens of the girls. So girls, filles, here is plural. So we have used des. Ce sont les stylos des hommes. Now, des hommes. Why des hommes? Because homme is plural. Starting with a vowel, no problem, but it's plural, so we will use des. And the last one is c'est la mère des enfants. This is the mother of the children. So enfant is plural again, starting with a vowel, no problem, but it's plural, so we will use des. Now again we have a note here. With proper nouns, de or d apostrophe will be used. D apostrophe with vowels. Those names which are starting with vowel, de will get converted to d apostrophe. Let's see how to use them with the help of a few examples. C'est la mère de Nikita. This is the mother of Nikita. Okay, now Nikita is proper noun, so we have used de, the, and not de la. Similarly, c'est la mère de Rahul. Again, Rahul here is proper noun. Even if it is masculine, we are not using du, we will use de. Okay, one more sentence. C'est la mère d'Annie. Okay, Annie is a name of a girl, feminine name, starting with a vowel, but we are not using de here, we are using the apostrophe. C'est la mère d'Annie. This is the mother of Annie. Okay, so I hope contracted articles are also clear to you. If you have any problem, guys, please do write me in comment section. I'll try to help you with all your doubts. So today we have covered les articles contractés in detail. Now, in the next part, we will cover les articles partitifs. We will see how to use partitive articles in French. C'est tout pour aujourd'hui. That's all for today. On va rencontrer encore. We will meet again avec les articles partitifs, with the partitive articles. Au revoir. Prenez soin de vous. Bisous, bisous.